This webinar series presents key findings from the School Nutrition and Meal Cost Study. This webinar focuses on findings related to satisfaction with the school meal programs and plate waste. The first webinar in the series provides an overview of the study, and four other webinars present key findings related to school meal program operations, compliance with the updated nutrition standards and the nutritional quality of school meals, school meal costs and revenues, and dietary intakes of school meal participants and non-participants. Starting in school year 2012-13, the school meal programs began to undergo widespread changes, including updated nutrition standards for school meals, additional lunch reimbursement for meals that met the standards, and rules affecting the price charged for full-price lunches. The School Nutrition and Meal Cost Study collected data in school year 2014-15 and was the first comprehensive national assessment of the programs since these major reforms began. Information about satisfaction was obtained from interviews with students and parents. The final analysis samples included more than 2,100 students and 1,850 parents. To assess the extent of plate waste in school meals, we conducted visual observations of lunch and breakfast trays in school cafeterias. The final sample included over 6,200 lunch trays and 3,600 breakfast trays. First, we'll look at student and parent satisfaction with school meals in school year 2014-15. Students who had ever eaten a school lunch or school breakfast were asked whether they liked the meals. More than one-third of students who had ever eaten a school lunch reported that they liked school lunches, but more than half reported that school lunches were only okay, and 12% said that they did not like school lunches. Student opinions about school breakfasts were more favorable, with more than half of students reporting that they liked the school breakfast. 40% of students who had ever eaten a school lunch responded always or often to a question about whether the lunch includes foods they like, but more than half responded as sometimes. 50% of students said that they always or often think that the lunch includes enough food choices, but the other half responded that the lunch includes only enough choices sometimes or never. Students were also asked their opinion on the amounts of food provided in school lunches. 73% of students thought that the portions were about right. Just under one quarter of students thought that portions were too small, and only a small percentage thought that portions were too large. This finding varied by school type, with a larger proportion of high school students reporting that portions were too small relative to middle and elementary school students. Parents whose child had ever eaten a school lunch were asked their opinion on the value of the lunches. 18% of parents thought that school lunches were a good value. More than half thought that school lunches were a pretty good value, while 20% thought they were not a good value. Next, we'll look at the extent of plate waste in school meals in school year 2014-15. Plate waste is a measure of the amount of available food that was discarded or not eaten. As discussed in the webinar on students' dietary intakes, school lunch participants had more nutritious lunches than students who ate lunches from home or other sources. But students who ate the school lunch didn't always eat everything on their tray. Waste in school lunches was highest for vegetables. An average of 31% of the vegetables on observed lunch trays was wasted. Levels of waste for milk were similar at 29%, followed by fruits and 100% juices, separate grain and bread items, and desserts and other items. Waste was lowest for entrees and meat alternates. These findings are consistent with findings from smaller scale studies that were conducted before the updated nutrition standards were in place. For school breakfasts, waste was highest for milk at 41%, followed by fruits and 100% juices. Levels of waste were substantially lower for meats and meat alternates, separate grains and breads, and entrees. Overall, an average of 21% of the calories available in school lunches and 23% of the calories available in school breakfasts were wasted. Levels of plate waste in school lunches were higher in elementary schools than in either middle or high schools, and were also higher in middle schools than in high schools. For example, in elementary schools, an average of 37% of the vegetables and 35% of the milk on observed lunch trays were wasted. In middle schools, about one quarter of the vegetables and milk on observed trays were wasted, and in high schools, less than 20% of the vegetables and milk were wasted. Not all differences were statistically significant. Comparable patterns were observed for all of the food groups examined. One factor that may in part explain the differences in plate waste observed across school types is the use of the offer versus serve option, which allows students to decline some components of a school lunch. Offer versus serve is mandatory in high schools, but optional for middle and elementary schools. The use of offer versus serve in elementary schools was associated with significantly lower levels of waste for calories and fruits and vegetables in school lunches. Among elementary schools, 26% of calories were wasted in schools that used the offer versus serve option, compared to 32% in schools that did not use this option. Findings were similar for fruits and vegetables. The study also looked at the relationship between the timing of lunch periods and levels of plate waste and found that later lunch periods were associated with a smaller but statistically significant difference in the percentage of calories wasted. In schools with lunch periods that started before 11:30 a.m., 20% of the calories were wasted, compared to 18% in schools with lunch periods that started at 12 p.m. or later. More information on these findings, as well as findings from the other study objectives, can be accessed on FNS's website using the link shown here. This includes the study reports, infographics, and additional webinars, including one that provides additional details on the methods used to estimate plate waste described in this webinar.